Hey everybody, welcome back to Northern Lion Plays Enter the Gungeon. I guess we're gonna do the pilot this time. If I had to rank the characters, let's keep the robot and the bullet out of it, because I don't have a good enough representation in my head of how they actually work in order to rank them. Think you got Hunter at the top. Like the item discovery, love the wolf skin. Crossbow can be pretty good for early game damage that you wouldn't otherwise have access to. Honestly, then I think you go Convict. Molotov is decent. Sawed off is horrible, but the picture is deceptively good. Maybe Marine after that. I don't know, they're all fairly well balanced in my opinion. I don't have one character right now that I'm like, man, this guy is just like the absolute worst. I put the pilot at the bottom just because, you know, maybe I would even put the Marine at the bottom. What does the Marine get apart from the starting armor and ammo drop? Ammo drop is a fairly shit active item in my opinion. Most of the time, you just end up getting something better, and then you use it in a kind of compromise. But you know what? We should have Austin on to talk about that shit. We shouldn't just be like, hey, here's the definitive guide to it. That should instead be like, you know, let's have somebody who actually knows what they're talking about. Come on. That's how interview shows work, you know? Jimmy Fallon doesn't know shit about anything, but then he has Angela Merkel on, and they talk about EU politics. That's not meant to be insulting to Jimmy Fallon. If you're from outside of North America, and perhaps you're unfamiliar with who Jimmy Fallon is. He's America's most popular actor. He was in our highest grossing movie of all time, Taxi, starring him and the Queen of America, Queen Latifah. And then the movie was ripped off by the nation of France during the French-American War of 2001 to 2015. It was a bitter time. Okay, you know what I mean. I actually, a lot of the internet hates Jimmy Fallon. Oh, he laughs at everything. Yo, Jimmy Fallon ain't for you, man. Jar of bees. Oh, we can't hold two items, so this could be good. Jimmy Fallon is for young parents who live in the suburbs. And I don't mean that in a bad way. I'm for it. I am for it. But he's not going to be like George Carlin's late night. You know, you think Amanda Seyfried wants to go on and talk with George Carlin about, you know, I know George Carlin is dead, I mean no disrespect to him, but you know, everybody wants to have like a Bill Hicks, you know, late night show. Amanda Seyfried is promoting her new movie, she's gonna come on and be like, hey, when was the last time you had a psychedelic experience that made you, you know, question the bounds of reality? That's not gonna happen. It's not how those shows work. It's there to be an affable good time. It's a variety show, just anyway, let's move on here. So far, so good. Don't really want to fight the boss right away. Got three blanks, gives us a better chance to flawless the enemy, or the boss. I shouldn't say gives us a good chance, because that may not be true. Oh, dude, when you land a roll in place, it is like an angelic butterfly from heaven itself descended upon you and just fluttered its little butterfly wings on your cheeks. It blessed you, is what I'm trying to say. Got a decent amount of money. Do I want to buy a jar of bees? I'm kind of tempted because it is a, it is an active item. However, I think I want to wait and see if we get another active item first. Because that brown chest could be a gun, which would make it probably not worth using anything but a lockpick on. Or it could be a passive slash active. If it's an active, even if it's a bad active, I'd probably rather buy keys than spend 38 on Jar of Bees, which is maybe just slightly better, you know? So, you know, the economy in Gungeon is something that I've... Oh, God. Not to get your panties all wet, but the economy in this video game has got some real interesting stuff going on. But I think it's kind of like the Trojan horse for, like, your skill or your strength in the game. You know what? We got lucky with that one. Gave us Winchester. I think this could be good for the boss fight. And that means that we are gonna have an active or passive in here. So let's go open that up. It's the cigarettes. I actually think, I don't know that this is good, but we've had it before. And it might not be bad. Is there any HP that I've missed on this floor? Yes, okay. Let's try to crank up that coolness stat right now. So we're gonna smoke twice and call me in the morning. There we go. That's early in the morning. You're supposed to be up cooking breakfast or something. Will we buy a key? Probably. They're gonna be as cheap as they've ever been on this floor, so. This saves us the money that we would have previously spent on Jar of Bees, and instead we get cigarettes. Is cigarettes better than Jar of Bees? Well, late game, they're probably both useless. Because I'm going to need my HP more than I'm going to be able to, you know, get the coolness stat from cigarettes once we get down to, like, bullet hell and beyond. Oh, what the fuck? He knocked down this chandelier on top of me. I don't even know if a blank would have saved us there. I mean, obviously I feel bad about that, but that was also, like, a bit of a freak accident there. Well, you know, that's even more so than... Oh, that was real bad. Even more so than, you know, the average in Gungeon, where I'm like, well, that was a freak act, or that was a bad damage, but at least it's a learning experience. This was, like, actually a huge learning experience. Oh my god, they gave me the heroin right off the bat. Heroin, be the life of me. You know what? We do have the opportunity to do the dew. The Mountain Dew. Now, we have the opportunity here to do, the Oubliette, and I kind of think that we may want to. It's gotta be that room right there. We have three keys, and we should be able to steamroll as a result of the heroin. Any extra HP that we get, and we're not gonna steamroll the whole game, we're just gonna steamroll the next little bit as a result of the heroin, but, we've got enough keys to have a really good chance at, getting some great stuff. I could let the lockpick decide, but I don't think I'm going to, because I think it's the right decision to come down here. Not always, but on the last two runs, it served us relatively well. Well, we don't know if it served us well on this run yet, but I'm going to do it! This is how you know I'm not just pumping these videos out as fast as possible. These Gungeon runs continue to be 45 minutes to an hour plus each most of the time, unless I royally fuck it up, which does happen. But I also think that, you know, there's a really good reason to come down here that relates to our cigarettes. The more HP we can get... The more we can use the cigarettes, the more our coolness stat will go up, the more HP and other consumables we get in the future. I'm kind of toying with this idea. It makes it sound a little bit more intellectual than it actually is, but I'm kind of toying with this idea that, maybe there's like a coolness build, where if you just get your luck stat high enough, then you stand to gain enough consumables to not really be, as afraid as I so often am on Bullet Hell itself. Now, the heroin is amazing. We've experienced this on any number of occasions. The only problem with the heroin, as I see it right now, is if we don't get ammo drops, there's a pretty big falling off between the heroin and the rogue special, or whatever the name of this gun is that we start with. But this floor, I feel, could be fairly pivotal for us. Plus, as the pilot, we get extra ammo. I'm starting to think that maybe, mere moments ago, I actually underrated the hero, or underrated the pilot. So now I'm like, man, he's got store discounts, he's got extra ammo capacity, but I still stand by the hunter at number one. Oh my god, okay. This is the Oubliette in a nutshell for me. I've never really gotten to the point where the Oubliette was as easy as it probably should be. Is embarrassing. Take heroin ammo over Winchester ammo. 25 heroin ammo is worth more than, you know, 50 Winchester ammo, I think. Gotta get some HP back. Don't be an idiot. Because if we die on the Oubliette here, I'd be super disappointed. Because the run is actually fine right now. Like, the run is potentially great. Getting the heroin early is a huge benefit for us. Another blank is nice. More ammo. This time, I guess, we'll take it for the Winchester. Let's go check out our shop. We got two chests coming on this floor, as well as whatever item we get for beating Blobby Lord. And there's ammo as well. The crutch. It's the, it helps your aim. I think we just take this. And then I may sell the Winchester to try to buy the crutch. Just take one shot. Oh, you're lucky, mister. You're lucky. Let's just make sure it is a junk salesman. And it is. Okay, so I may sell the Winchester, but I'd feel more comfortable doing so if we'd already gotten another weapon. that was better than the Winchester, just in case the heroine runs out of ammo. Okay, this, we just open this. Rolling deflects bullets. Oh no, slower enemy bullets. Okay. That's actually really good. I've had some wins with that. Again, as always, when I say an item is really good, don't take it as, you know, the be-all, end-all authority on Gungeon has spoken. Northern Lion says this item is good. These should all be prefaced by, in my experience, and from what people have told me, I think this is good. I could be wrong. So just be patient here. We played a little better recently. All we need to do, stay strong. The money's nice, but we're really in this for HP at this point. Good roll. Embrace the roll, man. The roll is not your enemy. The roll is your friend. If only these other enemies got hit by the bullets. Okay, we got two more enemies left. These are just the poison bulletkins, which are actually really easy. Basically on the same order as regular bulletkin. Bulletkins? These Gungeons and Bullet Kings. A little Tragically Hip reference, you know, I am Canadian. Didn't really, you know, the reference was inelegant. It's very fair to say. I will be thrilled to use a blank in that situation any day of the dang week. As long as I got blanks to spare, I think that's the right case to use them. I hate these guys, though. That room historically does a lot of damage to me. Somewhat embarrassingly. Ah, there we go. Half a red heart. Okay. So, I mean, I'm not thrilled with the fact that we took so much damage on this floor to begin with, but the fact that we're actually getting some HP out of this now is good, because, of course, we'll want to be using the cigarettes as much as possible to maximize our coolness stat. By the way, if you want to seem cool in real life, never say maximize your coolness stat. That's going to... You know, I'm not going to say that that's going to get your lunch money stolen. All I'm saying is that it probably doesn't sound as good outside of your head as it does in your head. But you know what? I don't know what's cool in this day and age. And beyond that, coolness is... Like, here's all I know about cool. Who's a cool celebrity now? If I ask kids these days, who's the coolest celebrity? Who are you going to say? Jimmy Kimmel? Probably not. Okay, I mean, I hate this. Where are these bullets coming? Okay, they're gone. The people who are coolest in, like, high school so oftentimes end up doing some very uncool things after high school. That's not to say everybody. Everybody knows somebody who was, like, really cool in high school, and then they grew up, and they're like, this person's still really cool. You're building houses in Thailand? That's fucking sick, dude. That's really cool. But then there's also, like, you know... Hey, check it out. Cool guy Jeremy got a $15,000 loan from the bank somehow. What's he gonna do with it? Put a bigger muffler on my car. Oh, Jeremy's so cool, man. Like, there's an element of that. I am gonna use the lockpick here. It's worked! Yes! Okay, so that basically is extra coolness for us. Ascribe to be the cool of Emmanuel, who goes to, you know, Nairobi to build some affordable housing. Don't be Jeremy, who gets a loan from the bank or uses his student loans to buy a gold watch or something like that. It's not worth it, Jeremy, I'm telling you. Be your own brand of cool, you know? You know what's cool? Being a dope-ass dungeon master. And I don't say that because I'm a dope-ass dungeon master. I've never played Dungeons & Dragons. That's how you know that I truly believe in my advice, because I didn't just say, hey, you know what's cool? Something I already do. Coolness is like following your passions and being unashamed by it. Sticky crossbow is fine. Oh, secret room has a chest. That is not a mimic, and it gives us a key. Blank for a key on this floor, I think, is a totally fine trade. Do we want the crutch? I think we want the crutch. In general, my philosophy has been buy passive items, and it's worked out fairly well, I think. Keys are cheap. Not cheap enough, though. My bad. Do we want to sell the Winchester? It's a tough call, because we do need something to kill bosses with, and the Winchester's been... I mean, it did kill the last boss. I don't really want to use heroin ammo for this. Let's just see how this looks. It's pretty weak, but you know what? It's getting the job done. And if this is our weakest enemy, and we're anticipating possibly just selling it anyway, we might as well use all of our ammo for it first. As long as it doesn't cost us too much in the realm of HP. Why am I still shooting here? You never fought this boss before? He's not there when you do that. Now, if we get armor here, will I use the old crest? If we get armor and HP, I'll probably use the old crest to get some benefit out of the cigarettes. Because I do think the coolness stat is extremely important. I'm hedging all of my bets on this run around that idea. I know it's not as cool as just dodge rolling through everything and winning 120 runs in a row, like some people we know. But, I really think that, being fiscally sound on this run seems like a sensible idea. I'm gonna rely on the free market forces to carry us to victory. Since we've already found the secret room, it doesn't really matter if we, oh god, be careful. It doesn't really matter if we use our blank here, so we should really use our blank to possibly protect our armor. I mean, the only benefit we can get out of it, barring a blank shrine, is avoiding getting hit. So, you know, why even risk getting hit? Two more hits should do it. Easy enough, used a lot of Winchester ammo there. And what is our item? The compass. We could take it instead of the lockpick. Wow, this guy's, like, stronger than you'd think, huh? I don't think it's worth... but on bullet hell it would be really good, right? But is it better than the lockpick or the cigarettes? Okay, I did use cigarettes there, which is actually what I meant to do. I'm gonna go a little lower than you might be comfortable with here, just to try to get that coolness stat cranked up. Take this. Cigarettes, sense of direction. I just want to check the Ammonomicon again. Always points towards the next descending elevator. I'm gonna say no to it. It does say surprisingly rare. Or maybe a sense of direction is surprisingly rare. I'm gonna say no to it. And I'm gonna give you my reasoning, and I've thought it through in my head, and I think my reasoning is relatively sound. First, we're gonna sell back our Winchester here, though. My reasoning is, it says it points towards the next descending elevator. In fact, moreover, it says it always points towards the next descending elevator. On the Forge, there's an argument to be made, I think, that would be useful. However, grab this key. I really want to find the boss on Bullet Hell. My logic right now is that on Bullet Hell, there is no descending elevator. Unless you're talking about the hand that grabs you on the Lich fight, which doesn't make sense to me. It's possible that it would still point towards the boss, but in that case, I take issue with the wording, and I think I can learn that for the future, but you can at least be like, that's sensible that he didn't make the interpretation that it points towards the boss there, and we'll learn from the future. You know, the game gave me information. I've played a lot of Magic the Gathering. One of the rules of Magic the Gathering is, you know, the card means exactly what it says. Sometimes that requires some interpretation, but even if it's a little confusing, the card usually means what it says. So you're like, man, that can't possibly mean that. It often does, if you have the correct interpretation of the rules. So I'm gonna go by the fucking card, in this case, and say no to the compass, with the admission that, admittedly, the compass could be amazing if it actually points to the boss, as opposed to the elevator. But, run is fine so far. Low on HP, which is disappointing, but good weapons. Sticky crossbow is totally fine as well. I don't know how it functions as a boss killer, but the heroin is so good that we don't need to have a great weapon for a while here. I don't understand why the heroin shows up all the time. It actually shows up on, like, probably more than half of runs, in my experience at least. Boss, or sorry, shop room has a bunch of HP, some keys, and is that the Jolter? It's not the Jolter, maybe it's Rubidine, I can't remember. Oh, careful. But for now, we really like, we have a very low barrier to entry for success on this floor. So I'm really hoping to kind of take advantage of the fact that we're a little stronger than the game and hopefully use the cigarettes a lot on this floor, but it would be helpful as well to get that, to get the flawless. So that, I mean, like, 7 HP is a little overkill, because oftentimes I end up just being stuck with empty heart containers when we get down to bullet hell. Of course, given the choice, you'd rather have it, but I don't think maybe getting, like, 6 flawlesses or HP upgrades is as important as perhaps I've made it out to be in the past. But it could be, especially if you can keep them full. Yeah, I think it's much more important to get coolness right now than it is to, maintain 1 armor. That armor is transient anyway, unless we never get hit for the rest of the run, or we think that we're gonna die on this floor. Which I hope doesn't happen. The coolness stat is semi-permanent, at least, so I feel like this is sensible. Yeah, I do think we just go for it. It's the Medusa. Medusa, the Gorgon. Ooh, I wanna have fun on the Gungeon proper. Have you ever read The Prince and Pauper? It's a Aesop's fable. Baby, why don't we go to the Medusa? We'll get there fast and then we'll take it easy. It sort of works. Okay, so the heroin is actually like, I probably fairly consistently underrated for boss killing purposes. It's doing a great job at wrecking the Gorgon here. Feel like that's when you use the blank if you want the flawless. It's like, why risk it, right? Well, it's not the best place to stand, but we did get the flawless. It cost us surprisingly little in the ammo department. Definitely smoke a cigarette or two. In fact, we can go a little harder on the cigarettes here because I think, you know, we're getting this HP and this HP, and we're getting that armor, and we got the Magnum, which is also probably fine. We still have one blank remaining. And let's do some exploring. We still haven't found any chests on this floor, so seems sensible to me to do some exploration here. This run is starting to feel pretty good. Not, like, amazingly thrilled with the item we got from the, with the item we got from the Medusa, but it was pretty good. We can use the Magnum for something, I guess is what I'm getting at. And I have to imagine that this is, like, our cigarettes are really amping up our coolness stat. That's why we're getting so many ammo drops, so many key drops. I could be mistaken, but I'm guessing that's the functionality in action here. Alright, lucky me. Looks like we got a treasure room coming up on our right side here. Probably 2 hits of the heroin should be able to finish the job, which is good. What? We did it. Okay. More enemies. I would really love some passive damage ups. I mean, when would you not, of course, but I'd really love some passive damage ups so that I could, yeah, we'll open this one for sure. Book of Chest Anatomy? No, military training, what? Anyway, I want the passive damage ups because they're good. Better reload speeds and weapon accuracy. I don't know if we need that with the crutch, but I'm not disappointed in it. And more exploring to do to find the second option here, which is going to be an active or passive. Obviously, I'm hoping for... Oh, wait, no, it's going to be a gun. Just because the last item had a picture of a gun does not make it a gun. All right. Well, we'll possibly use our lockpick then. But it depends on the quality of the chest. I think for a brown chest, I don't really want to waste a key. Not that it would be a waste, considering we do have 3 of them. It's not insignificant, but... probably better off saving that key for something possibly more valuable. Ammo drops are getting a little ridiculous here, but anything that keeps the heroin fully stocked is fine by me. Okay. more ammo. Does coolness only give us ammo chance to go up? Because that's a little silly. Alright, we're just gonna open that. And it's the blooper. I'm glad I did not use the lockpick, because if we'd fucked that one up, I would have been real disappointed. Get some armor, get another key, 69 credits, that's good. And this floor is pretty much gone, according to plan. Blooper is a really good gun. Oh, we got another shop. Oh, it's not a shop, it's a gun muncher. So if we... The gun muncher is supposedly tied to tiers, but I don't really want to put good weapons into the gun muncher because I actually like all the good weapons we have. Apparently, like, the charge shot is an A-tier weapon that I kind of dislike. So if we had, like, one of those and something else, we could maybe get better value out of it. You know what? I think we use a key, and I think we use another key. I never understand this item, but I'm going to use it. And it gives us an extra HP up, even though I don't understand it. I'm gonna take it and be thankful to have 5 HP, and that was well worth 2 keys in my opinion, even though the blank is worthless. And honestly, I think we just go down to the next floor. I don't really want to buy a key when I have a coolness stat that seems to be giving us a bunch. We could buy keys on the next floor, even though they'll be slightly more expensive. I think it's worth it to possibly have the risk to not have to buy a key. And by risk, I mean, I guess, promise. Chance? Potential? 25 minutes, we just finished the second floor, definitely on the slower end of Gungeon runs, but that's because we went to the Oubliette, and I think going to the Oubliette has served us well. We're on the Black Powder Mine here with 5 HP, 2 armor. The 2 armor I am not in the least attached to. I would relish any extra HP, gives us a chance to use cigarettes properly. Get some more coolness stat out of those. I really think that the coolness stat could be the crutch that carries us in this game, which is extra ironic because we just have the crutch, I suppose. Alright, that's the combo for those guys. Watch out for this guy. He should be dead pretty easily. Honestly, we should be really good on this floor as well. As long as the old noggin holds up. We have a weapon and enough passives that pretty much destroy enemies of this caliber that I'm not very concerned, but of course it could all go wrong based on my play. So let's hope that doesn't come to pass. But for right now, we basically have, you know, this game's version of Brimstone, except it doesn't scale nicely. It doesn't scale as nicely. It's still pretty good. Okay, this is a little tricky. Yeah, we got lucky that bullet probably disappeared. If not for that, we might have been in a tough spot. There we go. Just tie it out until these bullets break. So we get a key drop. The whole crux of this is that I don't want to buy a key, so I think I'm just going to pick it up now. Slight laziness, but that's okay. More HP drops, please. So I'm hoping for some stuff that we've had on recent runs that we could repurpose on this run as well. Like, for example, a YV shrine would be awesome. We must have one spinning. Oh, it's just one more bullet thing. Okay, another blank. Sure, useful for this floor. It would be nice to get the other flawless. Yeah, YV shrine would be excellent. Barring that, like, it's been forever since we had the ability to fly. Oh, come on with these shots. I got 2 different ways to aim easily. You'd think it would be not this difficult. We get like an ammo drop every 3 rooms right now. There is a key for sale. Fossilized gun is possibly good, but we need to have like a immunity to fire of some sort in order to feel confident taking it, because I really don't want it to, you know, cost me my own HP right now. It's valuable, if for no other reason than as fuel for coolness stats. I really feel like I'm locked in on this run, though. I'm not saying we're gonna get a lich kill, and it's not like a lich kill really matters that much when we're also trying to, you know, get the lich kill on the robot. However, it would be good for morale purposes. And I'm not talking about a mushroom that's popular in the culinary world. I don't know why I'm trying to save ammo. The ammo drops have been coming pretty fast and furious so far. But I'll take it. And the third... Oh, I hate these ghosts, man. It's the same principle as in Isaac. Like, when the zombies spawn, aka the knights, I always shoot at them too early. Smiley's revolver. Assuming the discount stacks between this and, yeah, it's the only places it could be here. Between this and our already disarming personality, the discount from the shop, this is pretty sweet. Can't deny it. I feel like we do have a damage upgrade already. I feel like previously, one harrowing shot was not enough to get through each phase here, but I might be mistaken. Free chest. It's the Derringer. It's horrible. It's a terrible gun. We got it for free, so I'm not disappointed. It's still gun muncher fuel, if nothing else. Alright, what do we got here? Wait, I was gonna say not the ammo conda, but that makes a lot of sense considering we are on the third floor. So, don't expect to find the ammo conda. Honestly, the heroin is kind of like all-purpose right now. I think I have a newfound respect for it after using... Fine, that was good. It was the right decision, at least. I have a newfound respect for it after using the Winchester to beat the fucking Blobby Lord. Okay, you know what? Get away from these guys. There you go. What you've effectively done there is reset the match. You know, there's no enemies on the screen anymore, except for the boss itself. A little dicey there. Whoop! Gotta kill the minions. Just stay solid here. How many times have we flawless the Treadnought at this point? Like, I have the power within me. Now that he's slower, like, I don't want to invite this evil in my life, but I almost feel like he's like a level 2 boss at this point. But before, it was impossible. Well, or at least very difficult. The heroin helps, though. Oh, big miss, possibly, but not really. Okay, so there's our next flawless. If we get armor, I'll probably try to use some cigarettes here. We did get armor, no HP, which is a little unfortunate, but it's not too bad. Definitely take heroin ammo. I still think you go on the cigarettes here. And I'll use, like, 4 of them. Well, it's, which is actually 6 of them, so there you go. We'll grab this armor piece. The boomerang, it's okay. In fact, it stuns all enemies, so I think I'm going to take it over the lockpick. Smiley's revolver is pretty good, but I would like to find a secret room here. Got a little bit more stuff left to do on this floor, I think, though. We're in a really good spot. I mean, my HP is lower than I'd like it to be, but that's just because I deliberately did that to get my coolness stat up. And honestly, I think the boomerang is a fairly effective spacebar item, or active item. I always have to remind myself that this is not Isaac. And on large open rooms here, the boomerang can actually... Oh, no. Don't stand there. On large open rooms, the boomerang can do a lot of good stuff. Just stunning enemies so you have a chance to kill one or two of them before they can actually react is really useful. Like, let's try that out. See how it works right here. This made my life much easier. Now, we do have to kill enemies from inside of the minecart. Has there ever been a better opportunity to get one? Possibly. 102 credits. We've done fine on this floor for keys. Don't need to sweat that. Do we have another item room? I can't recall, but sure we'll... The game will let us know one way or the other pretty quickly here. I maintain that I could have landed that shot. It's not about the damage from the boomerang, although there is a little. It's all about that stun. Oh, yeah, there's actually quite a lot left on this floor that we could possibly take advantage of. This is about the point where, you know, the fourth floor has been a little bit of a sticking point for me, but it's about the point on this run where you gotta be like, we got a pretty good chance to beat the dragon. Like, I would say that our dragon chances are very, very solid. The Lich is just a total crapshoot, because Bullet Hell is a total crapshoot, so I have no idea what's in store for us when we get down there, but I will say that for now, this run is, you know, everything we could possibly want it to be and more. Honeycomb is, at best, okay. Well, you know my... Well, we're not quite done yet, but You know my rule, or my methodology for the most part, when we come to the end of a floor, we haven't found the secret room. Typically, I am I'm a man who uses his flank on the shop. And I do believe this is our last room here. Boomerang also recharges really, really quickly. For crowd control purposes on Bullet Hell, this can be really useful. The extra key is nice. We did get rid of the lockpick. So let's go to our shop here. It could be up or down on the shop. It's possible. Alright, it's not possible. Do we want to buy a key? I'm gonna somewhat controversially say no. And my reasoning for that is... I want to have a lot of money left for... Oh no, you took my lockpick. I want to have a lot of money left for, the Forge, in case I want to buy one of those big items that can show up on the Forge, like Scattershot, for example, or I want to buy HP, which is also completely plausible. So, doing our little, like, you know, how are things going? Our little gut check here on floor 4. It's about as good as you could possibly expect it to be without getting, like, a really amazing, you know, chest or, you know, something along those lines. I think we've done a good job bringing ourselves back from... Not the brink, but from a slightly shitty situation after not flawlessing Gatling Gull. We continued the tradition of not flawlessing the first boss, but somehow still not getting punished for it because we got an HP upgrade later anyway. And as far as like spacebar items go, I think we're good. Getting a ton of consumable drops, which is nice. And honestly, the boomerang is making life much easier than even I thought it would. And I was for this item. So we're in the phase now where I'm going to try to stack up as much HP as possible. Then we'll talk about using the cigarettes after the boss fight. We might almost be at the point where we want to just save our HP. Because the HP that we have now is fairly likely to be representative of the HP that we're going to have when we get to Bullet Hell. Alright, so we really needed that stun. That was important. The only thing I dislike about this run right now is that using exclusively the heroine is kind of boring. It is also, like, the right decision. So I'm not gonna swap off of it. Let's not be ridiculous. But it is a little like, okay, this is our only weapon. I also want to point out, I don't think we've taken damage since the oubliette. And I don't point that out to say, like, oh, look at how good I am. Hey, everybody! Come see how good I look! No, it's more like, it's more like I'm just surprised. If we can get that happening on this floor, that would be nice. I don't want to put too much pressure on us. But, I have been flawlessing fourth floor bosses lately. And that's amazing to me, because I've been doing a shit job of flawlessing first floor bosses. Of course, you know, sometimes you just get overpowered. It's not always just skill. Took out the big guy. Super Boomerang Town. Not sure if there's like a skill component involved with Boomerang. Like if you throw it in a proper direction, it's going to be more efficient. Mostly I just take advantage of the fact that the Boomerang like goes around walls. And I just shoot it wherever I can. Watch out for this guy. God, I hate these enemies. Okay, I'd like to thank the brain of Northern Lion for actually choosing to work overtime today. You ran some great calculations there. In the future, if you wouldn't mind passing those calculations to the conscious part of the brain instead of exclusively leaving them in the cerebellum where the fight or flight instinct is contained, that would be amazing, but you know what? I'm just happy you hooked me up there. Certainly could have gone a lot worse. Did get to save our blanks as well, which is big. But I'm not relying on the flawless here. And honestly, once we get down to the fourth floor, the best part of the flawless is not even the HP container. It's just the fact that you get one extra red heart, which gives you a little bit more survivability in the late game that is to come. Full red heart. That's nice. We are getting to the point where I could use an ammo drop. That's what I get for being cocky about the fact that we've had so many ammo drops show up. Why am I even bothering trying to save ammo? It's stupid. We're never gonna run out of ammo. Only when all the ammo is gone will we realize we can't shoot money. Yo, that was pretty sick, though. Beautiful. Easy. And we've got a chest. That is not a mimic. Oh, it is a mimic! I was lied to! Thank you, Boomerang. I lied to myself about this mimic. Okay, what do we get? Oh! Ice cube. Items recharge while active. I really thought that was Heart of Ice, and I was super excited. It's not Heart of Ice, but it's not bad. So we got our blank back, and then, yeah, I think we fucked the armor, basically. And instead, smoked some cigarettes. Just, I really, really am giving this run an opportunity to prove that coolness matters. And, so far, I think it's working okay. The boomerang recharging while it's active might be worthless, or it might be amazing. Like, it could actually just mean that we can always use the boomerang. Okay, I hate being in sync with these bullets. Gotta do something like that. Oh, the controller's making me move. Yeah, we want to go on the upswing for sure. Or now! Yeah, that works fine too. Alright, I'm glad we didn't use a blank there. I mean, let's do it. Who we got? Wallmonger. Alright. Can we stun the Wallmonger? Not really, apparently. Heroin's working fine. No, he is not getting too stunned, is he? At least we're predominantly using one weapon. So even if it runs out of ammo, we got a lot of stuff backing it up. Oh, that was bad. I saw it coming, but it was like slightly too late for me to hit that blank reflex. Still, smart idea to use blanks to just make your life easier. I've already found the secret room. I guess there could be a blank shrine, but honestly, that's not that bad for a Wallmonger fight. I'm a little disappointed. I think we should have had a chance to get the win, but that's okay. We get the light gun, which I think is not really that good. But it could be an okay room clear for us later. All in all, I can be still pretty pleased with the way that fight went down. But, you know, we got hit twice and we have two blanks. So that's slightly damning. Ooh, ammo. So huge right now. Let's go exploring in this direction. So what have we found? We already got our passive, so the next thing is going to contain a gun. We could really use, like, a little bit more of a potent room clearer. Gotta be careful, because if you don't finish this room off fast enough, death shows up. Case in point. Nice. Don't really care about the blank, but if you could actually give me a blank shrine, then you can put these to good use. We do have a shop of some sort. Potion of Gun Friendship. I don't think Bullet Idol is very good. Bug Boots makes us immune to poison and regenerate poison. Potion of Gun Friendship over cigarettes? And it'll recharge while we're using it. Is Bug Boots also a speed upgrade, though? I don't recall. I think Potion of Gun Friendships, will beat cigarettes for us. So what's my play? Go a little hard on that. Get the coolness stat up. Goodbye, cigarettes. You've been good to me on this run, and I mean that sincerely. It's not you, it's me. And who knows if that HP is actually going to end up killing us. But I do think that Potion of Gun Friendship being active so frequently is going to be real nice. And maybe a nice kind of augmenter with the boomerang as well. Let's try it out here. So use the boomerang, pop Potion of Gun Friendship. Now, admittedly, the heroin is not normally your Potion of Gun Friendship choice. I'm just realizing that Potion of Gun Friendship may actually be worthless with the ice cube. But that doesn't mean it's... Oh, we got to open it. Gunbow can be great. That doesn't mean it's worthless, it just means it's not benefiting from the synergy. Potion of Gun Friendship is still quite good, I think. So we're gonna head down to the forge. Gunbow maybe on bosses. But it's a great room clearer as well, but so's the heroin, you know? So we're not really caught between a rock and a hard place. We just got two good choices. Not quite the same thing, so we're gonna Head down to the forge. We start with three blanks. I'm not totally sure why. I don't really love that one. I'm pretty extremely happy with where we're at on this run. And I think that's, you know, with reason. Now, if I know Gungeon, our next room is going to be the one with the fucking forge hammers, because it always is. Not a good shot. Good shot. Alright, we're out. It wasn't, but the, you know, it could have been. Okay, that was bad damage. And we're all familiar with this Northern Lion Shuffle now. Played pretty well for a little while. Fuck it up. Oh, that was bad damage. This is bad damage, you know. We gotta be careful to avoid that here. Thanks for the half red heart. I appreciate it. Potion of Gun Friendship is active again. I really don't see much reason not to use Potion of Gun Friendship for now, every time it's available. I think it at least gives us more damage. By the way, the boomerang with Ice Cube seems amazing. No forge, please. The fact that we can use the boomerang so often is kind of ridiculous. What? We found the boss fight? That's too early. No, this is not right. I mean, we could fight the boss right now, but the more I think about it, the more I'm like, maybe that's exactly the right decision. But it just doesn't feel right to fight the boss right now, you know? Ammo. Seems to make sense to take it for the heroin since we're still using that predominantly. I'd really like to stack up a little more HP. Fucking forge hammers, man. The absolute worst shit. Just, yeah, you gotta kill that guy. Boomerang's ready again. Like, look at how it's locking these guys down. This room can be hell. Instead, it really isn't that bad as a result of the fact that the boomerang is always ready. You know how Ashanti said, "I'm not always there when you call, but I'm always on time"? Whoa! The boomerang is always there when we call. I'll take the key, of course. Now, the real benefit of the, the real benefit of Potion of Gun Friendship is going to be on, you know, weapons that we have to reload a lot, or weapons where the rate of fire can really benefit. So we're not really seeing too much of that yet, but might as well open it. It's the Moonscraper. It's okay. Let's try. I don't think we're going to get much value out of it, but it's possible. Okay. The sponge is well worth a purchase. I'm actually pretty happy about that, and I feel like we should continue exploring. What's the point of having a dope coolness stat if you don't take advantage of your dope coolness stat? Oh god, it does stun the Thwomp. Life is good. Please. Anything to keep this Thwomp out of my business. There's our second key, which is exactly what we wanted. This is the last key we need for the entirety of the run, unless we find more locked doors. Solid. I would rather deal with this guy than a jammed enemy. I'm starting to think this one's got a shot, man. We got a map man, maybe? It is Map Man. Okay, so we do have an incentive to explore the rest of this floor. If we find a map on our shop, does it map every floor or does it just map this floor? Because if it maps every floor, it would be so useful to be able to be like, okay, that's where the boss fight is most likely to be. And then just rush it down. I think on this shop, we may end up just buying HP. Because I do think that's important, you know, 4 HP, I've been talking as if this run is, like, sorted, but 4 HP is not something to write home about. It's great for now, because we are very rarely taking damage, but That can change. All we're looking for now... Well, you know what? We might as well find the other item room and then explore every room. Because it does make sense for us to get Map Man sorted. And again, every extra room we do is extra coolness. That's the idea, anyway. Five blanks, dare I say, gives us a chance to flawless the dragon. Definitely opening it as a napalm strike. I don't think it's as functional as we would need it to be to replace one of our two items right now. Not that it's bad, because it's not, but let's be honest, it's not like we were going to use this key for anything else anyway. And I will say that this is... I'm not sure if this is the best I've ever played, but this has been a very good Gungeon run. In terms of, like, the amount of hits we've taken, because we have hurt ourselves. I was going to say the amount of damage we've taken, but we've hurt ourselves quite a lot on purpose to use the cigarettes with maximum efficacy. But in terms of the amount of hits we've taken from enemies, it's got to be, like, down there as far as the lowest ever goes, for me, personally. And I chalk a lot of that up to actually just using the heroin exclusively. Not confusing my brain, being like, hey, what weapons are we going to use for this particular section? Alright, so what's our go-to weapon for the dragon fight? I'm going to try out the gunbow with Potion of Gun Friendship. And I'm going to probably stick mostly to Potion of Gun Friendship, because the boomerang is unlikely to do very much for us. It's not going to stun the boss. There are minions that he can create, so maybe like we can use it... Should look into that, I guess. We can use it, Oh, dude, the broccoli is awesome, right? But is it a gun? I can't recall. Let's take it. It's just HP. Makes you strong. Is it just a huge damage upgrade? It's an edible green plant in the cabbage family whose large flower head is eaten as a vegetable. This doesn't help me. I mean, I believe that it's a good item, though. You do have a key for sale, but I doubt I'll be able to afford it. Have we been to every room? Have we been everywhere, man? Yes. Come on. Good gun. Good gun. Oh, he finally gave us the item for getting him on all floors. So we have, we've unlocked an item. The Unity. Commando. Commando is so good! Okay, so what are we gonna do with Commando? That's gonna be our go-to, Dragon fighter here with Potion of Gun Friendship for sure. Let's do it. I'm ready for sure. And 7 years ago, we hold these truths to be self-stealth evident. Nah, it doesn't really work. So Potion of Gun Friendship, it like looked like it was active. It got charged while I was shooting it, which is actually hilarious. Like, look at it. Watch the look. It's activated already. That's so funny. Is that doing a ton of damage? Oh, I blanked one of them. That's important. I think this is going really well. I was wrong, by the way. Potion of Gun Friendship completely works with Ice Cube. I'd like to hit you, like, more, if possible. Great use of a blank. I thought, hey, maybe we can save our blank. Why risk it? Why risk it? I don't want to risk the biscuit. I'm trying to get a Trisket. Just give me the biscuit. I don't know what this means at this point. Don't get, like, a high-pressure situation. We've killed the dragon flawlessly before. It's not like we're playing for keeps right now. Just be cool. Of course, you and I both know that we're actually playing for keeps. I'm just trying to keep myself, you know, not nervous. I think this... The gunbow seems like a fine weapon for this. I'm not going to overthink it. Wow. GG, Dodge Roll Games. Can't flawless the first boss. Can flawless the fifth boss. DAE. Balance. Look, I'm a little disappointed. I mean, I almost feel like maybe Blooper is our gun of choice there. Now, the problem with the blank is it doesn't blank all of these bullets. So we gotta be tactical in our use of it. Or just not use it at all, apparently. There we go. So we flawless the Dragon. That's exciting news. We're at 54 minutes on this run. If there's ever been a run that has a great chance of beating Bullet Hell, I think we've got the right combination right now. Yes, 7 HP, only 5 active. We didn't really pick up many red hearts on that floor. We only got hit once, but we only picked up half a red heart. So, like, we essentially broke even right there. I do have to say that this is one of the best runs I've ever had from a gameplay standpoint. And hopefully, even if we lose this run, which is very plausible, it at least puts to rest Northern Lion doesn't care about Gungeon, Northern Lion's not passionate about Gungeon. Look at this! We're knocking it out of the park right now. It's a 55-minute run. I'm enthusiastic. I can still sing a little bit. Gray skies are gonna clear up. Put on a happy face. We're rolling back prices all over the place. So put on a happy face. See, like, I'm present and accounted for. My voice cracked so far before that bullet actually hit us that I'm actually disappointed in myself not getting out of the way there. Okay, that blank is potentially huge. Does it make up for the damage we took? It honestly literally might. Oh, this is Boomerang City where the grass is green and the girls come back to you after you throw them away. There's some uncomfortable implications there I'm not happy with, but that's rock and roll, I guess. I think the heroine can carry us this whole floor. I got hit by one of those enemies trying to save a little heroine ammo. Then I used the blank because I got scared. I got spooked. Catastrophic implications to that damage we took earlier. Don't sweat it right now. You're still doing fine. You're on the level of HP you would be at if you hadn't flawless the boss. But you did flawless the boss. And remember, you know, when we fight the Lich... Oh, another blank. When we fight the Lich, he's not going to enter a weird phase where the gunbow all of a sudden is not the most functional weapon choice for us. So, I think we can be relatively happy knowing that that's probably going to be fine for us. Why so many jammed enemies? We got this powerful without picking up a single level of curse, and I think you're kind of, you're making me pay for it right now. Doesn't seem fair. Alright, well, the boomerang got stuck on a corner there. That's my own fault for assuming that this incredible weapon could navigate corners. Now, I know we found the boss fight early on the last floor. If there is to be the best chance possible of our success here, give us the boss fight early on this floor as well. I don't think I hit it. Ooh, that time I did, though. These boomerangs... I'm actually, like, on the verge of saying, like, the boomerang is one of the best active items in the game. As ridiculous as that may sound. The stun is so valuable once you get to a point in this game where there's too many enemies on the screen to, you know, for the average human mind to deal with it. Or at least my human mind to deal with it. I'm probably not average, either in the best way possible or in the worst way possible, depending on your perspective. Oh, careful. We have no keys. That was real close. We have no keys, which means that we may, you know this room is hell, by the way, so let's be cool here, but... We have no keys, which means we might want to shoot that chest. This dude got stuck behind the fucking thwomp. What am I supposed to do about that? Oh, just that. Okay, fair enough. We might want to shoot it, and we can maybe get some HP back, which would be real nice. 3 blanks, 4 HP is fine. I don't expect it to be this, you know, juicy forever here, but... So far, we've been handling ourselves admirably. Ammo, if it shows up... I don't think you rock the boat. I think you say, you know what? Thanks for the times you've given me, heroine. I appreciate it. And we're going to keep stocking you up because you've been good for us in the past. Even though I know we could use something more ammo efficient there, I'm relying on the simplicity of the situation to help my brain out. I'm sure there's some people out there. Why is this guy always talking about his brain? Yo, the brain is everything, man. The brain is the project manager of your life. I gotta have some respect for it. I gotta take its health into account in all available situations here. So anything that makes my brain's life easier makes my life easier, because I am my brain. The brain named itself also. I'm not sure if you guys knew that. I'm just joking. I mean, I guess it did, but... Yo, where's my boomerang at, though? Thank you, controller. Okay, we got heroin ammo. This has probably been the easiest bullet hell I've ever had. I hope that I didn't just jinx it. That was one of the best dodges I've ever had. I hope I didn't just jinx it. Okay, one's dead. Guy's about to get juiced up to the max level. We don't need to worry about ammo efficiency anymore, that's for sure. Oh, I hate this. Don't fear the blank. The blank is your friend. Only use it if you have to, but don't fear it. Using the blank is success disguised in failure's body. Using the brakes on your car doesn't make you a bad driver, it makes you a safe driver. Using the boomerang on a room doesn't, or using a blank on a room doesn't make you a bad player, it makes you a sensible player. It's not like we get any points for flawlessing the lich. Damage is damage is damage, man. Okay, 4 blanks, 4 HP. Still not convinced that we're the favorites here, but we gotta be getting close. In particular, what makes me excited is the fact that bullet hell has just gone well. Like, even more so than the fact that, like, we're, like, our present situation, our momentum is high, which is nice. Don't always get that, and by always, I mean ever, on bullet hell. So, the fact that I'm on bullet hell right now, and sort of feel like, yeah, make bullet hell twice as long, and I'd still be able to handle it, is a really good sign. Thank you, controller. Always thank the controller's auto-aim when you hit a shot from across the map. We've reached a landmark decision here, or landmark event. We have gained HP on bullet hell. It may not last forever, but there's a first time for everything, man. We're approaching the length of a bad feature-length film. These guys get super hard countered by the stun. Unfortunately, this guy. Oh, you tricked me! Oh, you tricked me! I don't know why I felt the need to go full on like Mike Myers impersonating a Scottish person for that one, but it's on the public record now. I have some nerves of steel to stand here. You might say, NL, have you forgotten about Potion of Gun Friendship? Not really. I'm just trying to simplify my life. You know the Spice Girls song, Spice Up Your Life? I'm doing the exact opposite of that right now. I'm simplifying my life, and I think that this simplification has been very good for me. Look at that, we picked up some freaking armor. The stun also is gonna... Oh, wait, we fucked it up. The boomerang did not hit. That's okay. We killed him before he spawned a skelly. Got another boomerang coming soon. I'm saving Potion of Gun Friendship for the boss, basically. We're gaining more HP. Oh my god, and we found the boss. Alright, this is Potion of Gun Friendship gunbo time. Try to land that shot like, straight on if possible. It's doing decent damage. That was bad, but hey, bees. You know what? Okay, good that you realized you probably have made a mistake here. What we do is just hold up, stop using blanks on this phase. Phase 2 is Blank City. Phase 1 is going just fine. I actually think it's better to take damage here. And just, you know, get ready for the next phase, which is, in my opinion, the trickiest phase of the Lich fight for sure. So we're gonna finish this oh, bad aim. Honestly, that went totally fine. We got 3 blanks remaining, 4 HP. Decent ammo for the gunbow, and the next phase of the Lich fight has a pretty large hitbox, I think. You have to wake up pretty early in the morning to trick me, Lich boy. I'm a lich, I'm a lover, I'm the final boss of Mother. I've never played Mother, so I have no idea if this is actually the case, but I'm a sinner, I'm a saint. I shouldn't have been hit twice there. You know the deal. You know the deal. That's not the shot you're trying to avoid. That was the shot you were trying to avoid. You know what? Blank him up here. Blank him up, blank him up, blank him up, blank him. Roll him in a circle of bosses and watch me rank him. Totally fine. Exactly the way I would have wanted to handle this, honestly. 3 HP, no blanks, potion of gun friendship. Gunbow's empty? Like, fully empty? Fully empty. Okay. Heroin. I think we will win. Don't really like... Oh, you can fall off the map. I still think we'll win. I'm getting more skeptical about the idea of a win. I'm very optimistic about the idea of a win. I still, like, I need to fight the Lich some more. So I actually know what attacks are coming. But look at that. Little tappy-tap shoot with the heroine. Finish the job here. I'm not sure if that's our first victory as the pilot, but I feel great about it regardless. Thanks for watching. I hope you guys have enjoyed the episode. Of course, we have the actual, like, you know, post-mortem and credits here and stuff. We played really well. We got really good selections of items. Bullet Hell was a masterclass as far as I'm concerned. Like, that's much better than I normally do on Bullet Hell. But for now, ooh, feels good to get another win under our belt. That's only the third or fourth time we've actually beaten the Lich. So, you know, work to be done. Most importantly, thank you to you guys for watching, and thank you to the game for giving me the heroine on the first floor. Without that, we might have found ourselves in a little bit more of a rocky time. We got a couple people to talk to in the breach here. For now, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the episode. If you did, click the like button. It helps out a great deal. Of course, subscribe if you want to see more in the future, and I will see you next time.